fresh squeezed.
John Rogers is a bit absent-minded.
I forgot my card.
That's why the CVS satellite can quickly process prescription insurance information.
Can it help me find my keys?
Even when you forget, CVS remembers. Irene Beckwith doesn't like crowds.
Neil, I have a question.
That's why CVS has low counters and a special consultation area so she can talk in private. At CVS, we're here to listen.
Excuse me, what does Timberland mean to you?
Nothing.
I want to tell about my baby. Beat the hovin' pies. She goes out of the way. Make me sound a fine. She's my baby. She's my baby. What a treat. Well, I can't call her sugar. Sugar milk.
Timberland, waterproof boots, shoes, and clothing.
Teens beaten by their boyfriends on the next morning.
This is a KYW3 sports presentation.
Hello again, I'm Lou Tilley. This is the Sunday Night Sports Wrap. And even with the Eagles taking this day off, we have a lot to talk about, a lot of catching up to do. I'm just back from 3 weeks on the road with the Phillies. I had hoped to be up in Toronto tonight, but the wild ride is over. And am I ever jet lagged? Not from the plane travel, actually, but from the emotional roller coaster that we've just been through, all of us, just from watching. It ended in the cruelest of fashion for the fans and players alike, with many questions, mostly about the manager and his closer. The case is far from closed. Let me say right up front that Mitch Williams takes the heat up front in the locker room afterwards.
Well, we got here and I let us down. So, I'm not going to sit here and make excuses for nobody. I just didn't get it done.
But you reflect on now what you can take out of this.
No, obviously what I take out of it is a loss. The only thing that's different about it is I managed to lose two games in the World Series.
Season's over.
And then a concerned teammate, Terry Mulholland, pulled the wild-eyed reliever away to a private players' meeting before this wild bunch came apart at the seams in the aftermath of the bitter defeat. They stood behind him with a familiar defense.
We would not be here without Mitch, and I told him that after the game. You have nothing to hang your head about. That guy gets paid to hit, and he came on top this time. You got to tip your hat to him.
You know, we're going to rally behind Mitch and let him know how much we believe in him, because he had a great season this year, and, you know, we expect big things out of him next year, and we'll go back at it again.
But someday, perhaps, they too might second-guess the wisdom of that century-old baseball theory that the manager has apparently studied that says in some, I'll dance with the girl that brung me.
Well, Mitch Williams has been our closer all year. I'm not going to change things. He's the guy that's done it for us. I just told him a few minutes ago that he's the one that got us this far, and I'm not going to change.
The problem with the dance metaphor, though, you probably don't pay the girl $3 million to dance with you. To dance well, to not step on your feet, to not break your ankle, to not break your heart. Fergusi's quest for fairness to his players ignores the fact that 24 others suffered for Mitch's second chance.
You, me, 5 million others in the Delaware Valley watched it unfold. Watched the relief somehow put goose eggs up there 3 innings in a row. But to the ninth, very few healthy arms left. And Mitch Williams had his chance for redemption.
I felt great. Coming into the game, I felt really good. I didn't throw strikes to Henderson, which was, I mean, what can I do there? I didn't throw him strikes. I can't put him back at the plate. I got to try and get the next guys. I got the next guy. Mulder hit a pretty good pitch into center field. And then I made a bad pitch to Carter.
Where is it written that in the sport of baseball, you use the same strategies in October because they were effective in July, when Williams' fastball still had bite? By this World Series, hitters had to struggle to slow their swings enough to keep the ball in play. This is unlike any other sport. In football, Randall Cunningham took a seat
after 16 regular season games when his team was trailing in the playoffs. In last summer's NBA Finals, veteran All-Star Kevin Johnson was benched in favor of an aging Danny Ainge and Frank Johnson. But Fregosi stuck with Mitch Williams to lose Game 4 and Game 6 in the most bitter of ways.
We would not be here without Mitch Williams, and that's bottom line to that.
Mitch Williams is here ever destined to own a place in the Philadelphia version of Webster's Dictionary, right next to Yo, as in, Yo, did you see him blow that game? Fill in the sport. He pulled a Mitch Williams, or in time, he really Mitched it. But not from the Phillies, at least not now.
You know, the thing that upsets me is, and I'll say it now, I'm glad we're on Philly TV, the few guys or, you know, whoever they were, you know, thought they were being cool or tough. A few death threats they gave Mitch back in Philadelphia, you know. I don't know if they think they're helping us or what, but they hurt us, you know. The guy didn't sleep a whole night. He missed a workout yesterday, and he slept 20-some hours, you know, 22 hours making up for yesterday. And I don't think he was feeling right today. That kind of rubbed me the wrong way because I saw how it affected Mitch. You know, he didn't sleep the whole night. He had police around his house and, you know, that kind of stuff. You don't know about it. You don't think it happens in a game in baseball, and then you get in the World Series and see it happen. And you know, it's just not right.
In the end, it was the Phillies pitching in general. Take away Schilling's gem, and the Blue Jays scored 8, 4, 10, 15, and 6, hitting 363 as a team and close to 500 when you factor in the walks. The jungle rotation featuring the left-handed starters flopped. Mulholland and Jackson allowed 17 runs in 19 innings over three starts. Besides Schilling, only Roger Mason distinguished himself. And speaking of which...
Did you feel like you had much left?
Yeah, I think I could have gone more. But, you know, Jim's used the bullpen the same way all year. You know, he's had success doing that all year long, and, you know, the sixth game of the World Series is not the right time to all of a sudden change the way you've managed.
Ah, baseball dogma again. An atrocious David West was called in to pitch lefty to Allroad behind Mason. But if you're following that philosophy, why Mitch, the lefty, and not Tommy Green to pitch to Molitor and Carter in the ninth? All of which probably left you teary-eyed in the end. And I was surprised to find the always emotional Bill Giles moving easily through the locker room afterwards, very much in check, and summing things up like this.
To be honest about it, we talent-wise and money-wise, didn't match up to either the Braves or the Toronto club, and we were able to beat the Braves and to go to, you know, this tough loss today. And so I'm very, very proud. I've never been more proud of a team than I have in my life than this team.
The Phils of 93, so brilliant, so painful, but then isn't that why we're all hooked? And still, I know I rediscovered baseball this year. And even with the excruciating way it ended, you have to feel it's not quite over yet and that the future is still bright where it comes to baseball in this town. More sports coming up on the Sports Wrap, and this is what's ahead right now. First of all, from the football wars, coming up later, and stick around for this from the baseball, the Blue Jays have their say.
I got one message for the mayor of Philly.
Todd Stottlemyre with a high, hard one from Mayor Ed Rendell. And the play-by-play on this day in pro football. The two-minute drill is coming up in about 2 minutes. We'll be right back.
Our next speaker's high school class voted her most likely to go places. Instead, she stayed right here in her hometown and became our banker. Well, it's lucky for us because she's going to help us spruce up the playgrounds in this town. Ellen? Maybe she'll just give us the money.
Not a chance, George. But I do have some ideas on how we can get the money we need.
In the communities where we work and live, we've learned that banking is all about one thing, commitment.
Jim Florio is trying to mislead you with negative ads about criminals and drunk drivers. It's a cheap shot, and he knows it. I'm the mother of two teenagers. I know what it's like on a Friday night to worry about drunk drivers while my kids are out of the house. As governor, nobody will be tougher than me on drunk drivers and criminals, especially those who prey on women and children. And I'll continue to support the ban on assault weapons. So the next time Jim Florio tells you I'm soft on crime, remember, if he can't tell the truth about raising taxes, how can you trust him to tell the truth about me?
My family and I, we've just moved into town.
We all love it here, yeah.
But what we need now for a certain little girl is a really good, friendly pediatrician. One with a big supply of dinosaur stickers?
The way we screen and we check, you're going to have a great choice of pediatricians and hopefully not a bad choice of dinosaur stickers. So let's see if we can help.
Aetna Health Plans. The more you know, the better you feel.
In the Camden County Assembly race, there's John Maraccia, using his inside connections to take $250,000 of taxpayer money. And there's Jane Kirshner, who raised taxes and spending in Haddonfield. As a team, they've already said they'll raise your taxes. Here's our reply to that. Dr. John Rocco and Lee Solomon. They cut state spending $1.3 billion and taxes $600 million. They've saved our schools and are backed by our 32,000-member State Police Benevolent Association. It's Rocco and Solomon for Assembly.
Welcome back. The Eagles take another Sunday off on this day, along with most of the NFC East, but not all. Here's what happened today, machine gun style. Start the clock. It's our two-minute drill. First from the NFC, Phoenix at San Francisco, where the Cards were looking to fatten up their 2-4 record, with the 49ers on a diet of rice. Jerry Rice with a pair of TDs, including this from 8 yards. The only upset in this game happened in the parking lot as the Niners set the table 28-14 over Phoenix. Atlanta goes to New Orleans, and Bobby Hebert back at work in the Superdome. Hey, don't those fans love him? But Hebert had the last laugh. He tossed 2 TD passes, this 5-yarder to Andre Rison, as the Falcons upset the Saints 26-15. Detroit at the Rams, and quarterback Jim Everett yanked. Replaced by T.J. Rubley, who comes back from a 13-0 deficit to tie it with this to Ernie Jones. But they miss the extra point, and Jason Hansen's kick for Detroit, his third of the day, wins it for the Lions, 16-13. Battle of the Bays. Green Bay at Tampa Bay. And Packer quarterback Brett Favre had quite a day. He brought Sterling Sharp along, and it's a good thing. They connect 4 times for touchdowns as Green Bay wins it 37-14. Crossing over to the AFC in New York, Bruce Coslet's Jets. He signals the play in from the sidelines, but apparently Boomer misunderstood and fires it to the Bills' Darrell Talley. And he's off and running 61 yards for the Buffalo touchdown. The Bills handle the Jets. 19-10 is the final. Great game, Pittsburgh at Cleveland for the division lead in the Central. Steeler coach Bill Cowher trying to hold on late. He did not count on this. Eric Metcalf had already returned one punt, 91 yards for a score. With 2:05 to go, he's at it again. This one of the great plays of the day. He goes 75 yards for another score, the winner, as the Browns come back late for the 28-23 win and the lead in the Central. Cincinnati at Houston, and Oiler fans might be a little gassed up, but not Warren Moon, who throws for 2 touchdowns. This a 9-yarder to Gary Wellman as the Oilers win it 28-12. New England at Seattle, and Bill Parcells watches a field goal contest for 59 minutes, 35 seconds. The only score here, 25 seconds left as Meyer hooks up with Blades for the winner. Seattle on top, 10-9. Now the Dolphins tonight don't miss a beat without Dan Marino. They thumped the Colts 41-27 behind Scott Mitchell tonight. Well, Ray Didinger, pro football's traveling troubadour of insight. In Friday's Daily News, he picked the Falcons upset of the Saints, and with that as credential. Is there a dominant team in the NFL right now?
No, there really isn't. Normally at this time of the year, we're looking around trying to decide which is the dominant team in each conference, which are the teams that are going to go to the Super Bowl. I think the question right now is there any good team out there in the National Football League right now? You know, you look around, and the New York Jets have half the package. They're number one in offense, but they're 18th in defense, and they've blown second-half leads in each of their last 3 games. It looks like that collapse against the Eagles really turned their season around. And they say defense wins in the NFL, so Minnesota should be in good shape, right? Sure. Not with the 24th-ranked offense. The Vikings have scored 5 touchdowns, which is the fewest in the NFL. Denver's scoring lots of points behind John Elway, but their defense can't stop anyone, especially through the air. Mm-hmm. And Pittsburgh's playing great defense, but they too have a glaring weakness. It comes on special teams, where their kick coverage has been the worst in the league, and it really cost them today when Cleveland's Eric Metcalf brought back two punts for touchdowns to win this game at the Dog Pound and stake out first place for the Cleveland Browns.
Mm-hmm. Now, Saints started off so well, as they have in the past, but again, they start to fade. But, of course, they've had some problems defensively.
They've lost 10 regulars on offense and defense with injuries, mm-hmm. and they've lost Sam Mills, who's their signal caller on defense, inside linebacker, and their best run player. And in each of the last four games, they've had at least one opponent rush for over 100 yards, which is very uncharacteristic. So after a 5-0 start, they've now lost two in a row, and they're back with the pack.
So who do you look for to come out of this thing right now in the AFC anyway?
Well, in the AFC, the ironic part about it is the team that looks the best and the team, if you had to say, was the most likely to go to the Super Bowl, scary as that thought might be, it's the Buffalo Bills.
No.
That's right, the team that's lost the last three Super Bowls and the team that we least want to see back in the Super Bowl is playing the best. They're number one in giveaway takeaway, and as we all know, those teams rise to the top.
So are we going to recue the tape? Is it going to be Dallas from this league again? I don't see anybody else in there from the NFC.
Well, right now the NFC, the team that's playing the best is the Dallas Cowboys, and they're the team we're going to be seeing here next, a week from today.
And that's what we're going to be talking about next as well. We're going to go to another break on the Sports Wrap and queue up another stack of tapes. We're going to focus on the Eagles. When we come back, they have an off week, but they better be at work. They'll be our lead again next Sunday after they finish locking horns with the Cowboys at the Vent. And the Highlight Zone is coming up, mostly football, mostly for fun, still ahead on the Sports Wrap before we're done.
These two women want to help change Camden County government. Annette Deegan, a teacher and educator. Aletha Wright, a leader in the reform effort to get people off welfare into jobs. They want to make our streets safe, ban assault weapons, and support mandatory sentences for violent criminals. And they want to end welfare as we know it by moving people off welfare, retraining them, and requiring them to work. Aletha Wright, Annette Deegan, Reform Democrats for Camden County Freeholder.
Fall is here.
And winter is coming.
It's time to get to your Subaru dealer's Silver Anniversary Celebration.
Ask yourself, when was the last time your family drove here?
Or here.
Then ask yourself, why pay well over $20,000 for a sport utility?
When you can buy selected legacy all-wheel drive wagons for thousands less.
And that's before up to $3,000 in year-end savings.
Subaru, America's best-selling import wagon for 11 years straight.
With our rugged winter weather on the way.
And up to $3,000 in savings.
You can't wait another minute.
Subaru, it just makes sense.
Meet Supreme Court candidate Ron Castile. Castile has no experience as a judge. He's a politician who ran for mayor of Philadelphia and lost because of controversy. Now the political bosses have picked him to run for yet another job. But Castile is so scared he's not qualified that he's tried to keep one candidate off the ballot and run a negative campaign against the other. Worse, even the Bar Association has given Castile low ratings. We need integrity and ethics on the Pennsylvania Supreme Court, not Ron Castile.
Did you know some heart attacks never cause chest pain? Jefferson has developed a 40-page guide to help you recognize symptoms of cardiac problems and to find quality in your treatment and care. What's interesting is it discusses what to look for when you're choosing your cardiologist and hospital for treatment. It contains statistics confirming Jefferson's quality, as well as practical advice on prevention. To receive your free copy, call 1-800-JEFF-NOW.
Yeah, here's today's honor roll. The 100-yard rushers for the day. Eric Tigrum of Atlanta, 132 in their win. Thurman Thomas of the Bills, 117. They won. The Rams' Jerome Bettis with 113. And Darrell Thompson of the Pack checks into the lineup and checks in with 105 yards. And in the late game, the Dolphins' Mark Higgs rushed for 114 yards, a key in their 41-27 win. 300-yard passers today. Neil O'Donnell of the Steelers leads them all with 355 in the loss at the Dog Pound today. And the Cardinals' Steve Berline, most of that in the mop-up role at garbage time, well after the issue was decided, trailing 28-0 in Atlanta, or rather in San Francisco. He came back with two late touchdown tosses and 335 yards on the day. Meanwhile, the Eagles have a date with Dallas next week down at the Vet. Both teams at 4-2. You would think this would be a clash of the Titans, but on paper, it looks like a mismatch. Game time has been changed to 4 p.m. Not too many people give the Birds much of a chance on this one. Ray Didinger surprised me, as I said, with his pick of the Falcons over the Saints today. How do you see the Eagles and Cowboys shake up this time around? A lot different than a year ago, I know that.
Yeah, the Cowboys are a team that are really hitting their stride. They lost their first two games this season while Emmitt Smith was holding out. We all remember that. But since he's returned, the Dallas Cowboys have been quite simply the best team in the league. Once again, they're showing the balance that took them to the top last season. They're second in the league in offense and a rapidly improving sixth on defense. Check these numbers. The Cowboy defense has allowed only two touchdowns in the last 13 quarters, and they have seven takeaways in their last two games. On offense, yes, it helps to have Emmitt Smith back, but it really has been the Troy Aikman and Michael Irvin show. Aikman leads the league in passing, and Irvin leads all receivers with 416 catches for over 700 yards. To put those numbers in perspective, if Irvin were to continue at that pace, he would finish the season with 123 catches for 1,899 yards, which would smash all the known records in both the United States and Canada. It's hard for me to see how the Eagles can defense this team in its current condition, and Emmitt Smith has averaged over 140 yards rushing his last two games against the Eagles, and the Cowboys have a guaranteed mismatch with Irvin and Alvin Harper, both of whom are 6'3", taking turns working against the Eagles' 5'7 cornerback Mark McMillan. This could be a long, long day for the Eagles.
I'm not sure if I want to come to work next Sunday after listening to that. How do the Eagles do it on defense? I know Bud Carson has made it happen with his smoke and mirrors defense, but now that defensive line, when I turned on the TV from Toronto last week, I hardly recognized the guys who were in there. There were numbers that I didn't even see in preseason camp. How can they get it done?
It's going to be very difficult. I think you've seen that Andy Harmon has played some inside. He's played some outside. Bud, the smoke and mirrors analogy is a pretty good one. They're going to have to blitz a lot. They're going to have to use their linebackers and safeties and run support. That may be the only way you can try and keep Emmitt Smith in check. The only problem is if you begin cheating that kind of concentration at the line of scrimmage, it leaves you way, way open for play-action passes to the Harpers and the Irvins. As I said, if Bud Carson can keep this one close, he will indeed be the master.
I know this has always been a key for me when I watch the Eagles' defense. When I see Eric Allen making a lot of tackles, I know they're in trouble because that's not his primary function out there.
And remember, this team is really having trouble rushing the passer. This is not an Eagles defense that we remember from the past. They have the fewest sacks in football, and if you can't get pressure on Troy Aikman, I don't know that you can beat the Dallas Cowboys.
This is what confuses me. When I see Randall go down and Brister take over, I figure, hey, they still have a pretty solid offensive line, and their running backs, which we were also excited about in preseason, they're going to turn into a running team, keep the scores down, keep the score close. What happened to that?
I'm kind of at a loss to explain that. I thought in the Bears game and the Giants game, they started off with a pretty good game plan and pretty good concentration. They ran the ball well. They had a big time of possession advantage. I thought they had kept the games close. The other teams got a bit of a lead, and I thought the play calling began to panic a little bit. I thought they opened it up way too soon. They got into situations where they were throwing the ball more than they should. I really think it's critical against the Cowboys, particularly since their run defense is a little weaker than their pass defense right now, that they run the ball, stay with the running game, try and shorten the game, and just keep it close and hope that they can win it with a break in the fourth quarter. If they open it up, I think they're really, really tempting fate here.
Now, does the function of the running game change any with the fact that it looks like Ken O'Brien will be back there? I mean, the guy's almost as old as me.
His knees are a little bit better than yours.
Thank you very much,
think.
Yes.
But I think they're going to have to scale things down a little bit for O'Brien for the simple fact that Brister and Cunningham are both guys that are capable of making some plays outside the pocket.
Right.
O'Brien never has been that kind of player. He had a few mobility type of plays that he made against the Giants, surprising in that respect. But I think to be effective, he's going to have to be a pocket passer, and it's going to all have to work off the run. If they can run the ball and get him into some good short yardage situations where he can play action, he might be able to make some plays because he's smart and he still has a good strong arm. The comparisons, people are trying to compare him to Pat Ryan. He's a much more productive player now than Pat Ryan was when he came in, but he's going to need help to get this team over the hump.
Ray Dinger, nice to see you again, and you can read him, of course, in the Daily News and sometimes hear him on WIP Sports Talk, All Sports Radio. Thanks for joining us tonight for a
My
little
pleasure,
talk man. With our fans. Time for a break right now. We'll be back with more on the Sports Wrap, the Highlight Zone, and a final word. A final word from Toronto pitcher Todd Stottlemyre for the mayor of Philadelphia. Let's just say the Jays didn't win it with class, and I'll explain later.
Most people already know that a GMC Jimny comes with features that give it all the strength of a truck and all the ride and comfort of a car. But what you may not know is that right now, it also features a lease that's never been more comfortable. The all-new Jimny 24-month lease. Get to know one today at your Delaware Valley GMC truck dealer.
The Burlington County Times reports State Senate candidate Jack Casey boasting about running a vigorous campaign. But now we've learned Jack Casey has taken workers' compensation money for the past 7 months because, are you ready? He's too hurt to sit at a desk at work. He can knock on doors, sit in TV studios, kiss babies, shake hands, but he can't go to work? Right. The fact is, Jack Casey is ripping off the system, and that means higher health care costs for the rest of us. Jack Casey, sticking it to taxpayers. Again.
With an ordinary single-tank wet-dry vacuum, you can't clean up the dry stuff until you've cleaned out the wet tank.
Can't anybody make this easier?
Hoover has. Kmart introduces the new Hoover 12.5-gallon wet-dry vac with the exclusive two-tank system designed to go instantly from wet to dry cleaning without emptying the tank or changing the filter. An 8-piece attached tool set, cartridge filter, and tank drain make it perfect for the shop, garage, patio, and basement. And it's just $89.99, now only at Kmart.
Shirley and Joe both have ulcers. Joe chose his company's traditional health plan. He has a large deductible for doctor's office visits, hospitalization, x-rays, and lab tests. Shirley chose Greater Atlantic at her company so she wouldn't have to worry about the cost of doctor's office visits, deductibles, and claim forms. Joe chose the right woman, but the wrong health plan. Greater Atlantic, the coverage you need for 100% peace of mind. Ask your employer.
Ah, here I was getting all down about the Phillies losing in the World Series. And look at this. The Sixers beat the Bullets 105-103 in preseason basketball tonight down in Mobile, Alabama. Their first win of the preseason. See that? There is life. There is always a silver lining. Here it is. Time to wind down with the ups and downs of life in the National Football League on this Sunday night. We call it the Highlight Zone. The Steelers in Cleveland today trying to get pumped up against the division rival Browns. They pack a Vinny's sandwich for the trip home to the Meadowlands where the Bills and Jets put their heads together. I love that. Hey, the Colts at Miami. Remember, Keith Byers used to run for the Eagles and throw too. And he scored a touchdown to Fryer tonight. You got to take your hats off to Miami. In fact, they'll do it for you if you want. The Highlight Zone for this week, but nothing can beat this. It's tonight's parting shot. And it comes from the victors. Now, I don't know if Blue Jay pitcher Todd Stottlemyre spent the night on Yonge Street himself with the rest of the 200,000 or so who turned the town upside down last night. In fact, they were still out there when I left my hotel for the plane at 5:45 this morning, those crazy Canadians. But something was buzzing around his bonnet. He was still miffed that our mayor made a crack about his pitching in the playoffs. Stottlemyre taking a parting shot at their rally today.
I got one message for the mayor of Philly, and I hope you're out there looking. You can kiss my ass.
Hey, what's that all about? I guarantee you right now, Ed Rendell's going to make darn sure that guy pays his three games worth the Philadelphia wage tax. Talk, not action. In game four, Stottlemyre just about made us forget about Bert Hooten. These things have a way of coming around again, and I hope so. Until we come around again, until next week's soap opera of sports, I'm Lou Tilley, and that's a wrap for the Sports Wrap. Good night, everybody.
Ben Lynch's assembly candidate, Sandy Love, promised a home for seniors, but she squandered our tax dollars and left them this empty field. Lynch's other candidate, Sean Dalton, took political payoff money from the corrupt Camden bosses. Now Ben Lynch wants to raise the sales tax back to 7%. So let's stay with Senator John Matheson and assembly members George Geist and Jenny Weber. They cut taxes, cut spending, and they're working for jobs.
While you're finishing...